Okay, you have understand for overview picture, overview part of the nature of the VAT collection. Okay, to check your understanding, I have the some of the example of the transaction and some of the question to check your understanding. If you can answer for this question correctly, it can be assumed that you understand for the nature of the VAT already. And next step is that you in each factor that related to the VAT consideration, you have to understand and know the criteria, know the detail of the regulation. Okay. Let's try for the question. Example that the transaction is A sell the share to B for the cost of the product at 100 baht. Okay, so A is seller, B is a buyer. Okay, A is seller, B is buyer. Consumption of this kind of the goods is incurred in this transaction or not? Consumption on goods is incurred in this transaction or not? Okay, the answer is yes. Okay, and we assume that the share is the VAT product. So in this case, this transaction will be subject to VAT. If you have the VAT to be charged on this transaction. Next question, who would pay the VAT? In this case, who would pay the VAT? Can you answer? Who would pay the VAT? Who would pay the VAT? By the law, seller, that is Mr. A, will be the payer of the VAT. Okay. However, since VAT is a kind of indirect tax, VAT is a kind of the indirect tax. So A, they will push that tax burden, that tax liability under the law to the consumer by charge it into a part of the price and call it as VAT to be collected by the law. So the person who consumes the product, who buy the product, will be the person to pay VAT by the economic. So Mr. B, that B will be the payer by the economic. But A, who are the seller, is the payer by the law. Who has role and responsibility to charge VAT? Who has role and responsibility to charge VAT? By the law, the person who sells the product will liable to charge VAT. So Mr. A, that is a seller, they have the accountability, responsibility by the law to charge VAT. And Mr. A will submit the number of the VAT that they collect from the buyer, that is Mr. B, to the revenue department in each month. In Thailand, we use monthly basis for the VAT collection by calculating of the output VAT minus input VAT. So if we focus on the cash flow in or flow out, okay? If we focus on the cash flow in or flow out, and assumption is that A and B, both of them are VAT resistant. Both of them are VAT resistant. A buyer, that is B, will have the money flow out in total of 107 baht. Okay, when A sell to B 100 baht, B pay the money, pay the cost of the product to A, who is the seller, for 100 baht. By the way, since A is a very distant div, A will charge for the VAT for another 7 baht. So money will flow out from B to A for a total of 107 baht. A, who is the seller, has the money flow in for 107 baht. But A has the duty to bring the number of 7 baht, remit or submit to the revenue department. We assume that in this case, we exclude the way for the condition of the calculation first. Just look in for one transaction. The mechanism of the transaction, if we still not required to calculate for the VAT liability in each month. So in each transaction, A receive money for the product or the cost of the service that they provide to the buyer. But in addition, they will collect for the number of the VAT that they charge to the buyer together with the price of the product cost. So total of the money that A received will include VAT. And that transaction, A has the accountability and all responsibility to bring the number of the VAT that they collect from the buyer to remit to the revenue department. If B is a VAT resistant, VAT that they have been charged by the seller, that is A, will call it as input tax. And A call this one as output tax. Okay, so you can see that if you back to the part of the corporate income tax, section 65 bis number 11, they said that output tax is not income. Output tax is not income. So you can see that in this case, you can see A will have income only 100 baht, although they collect 7 baht from the buyer. Okay, so in addition, for the section 65 there about the VAT, it cannot be deductible expense except for some exemption that I recommend you just remember for the VAT on passenger car and all the VAT on the entertainment cost. However, it has a lot of kind of the VAT that is not claimed as input tax, but it is allowed to be deductible. By the way, generally input tax under the section 65 there, number 6, it says that input tax is not expense. So if you look into this row of the transaction, number of the VAT, if they are well registered, it will be called as input tax. So it means that when they're making the calculation of the VAT liability in each month, number of the VAT, the VAT registrant who is the buyer, they have the right to claim the number of the VAT that they have been charged by the seller to offset with the output tax that they charge to another, they charge to their customer. So this is the mechanism that why input tax is not deductible expense in the corporate income tax calculation. Exemption for VAT on the passenger car, although it is in this mechanism, by the way, it is a VAT that generates from the original transaction, that is the passenger car product or the passenger car services. So this VAT in the calculation of the VAT, this will be as non-deductible input VAT. It means that they cannot claim the input tax on the passenger car in the VAT calculation. When they cannot calculate as a input tax, and it is not prohibited under other case, VAT on the passenger car is allowed to claim as the expense to deduct as from the revenue to take the calculation of net profit for the corporate tax calculation. Okay, these are the mechanism. So When B charge to C for 300 baht, the money will how it can flow in, flow out if we change the transaction between this one. B is the seller and C is buyer. Okay, as same as the transaction, money will flow out from buyer who is C, total of 321 baht. For 300 baht is the cost of the product or the service and 21 baht for VAT. Money will flow into B in the position of the buyer, the seller, for total of 321 baht. Money flow in for 300 baht will be the revenue. And 21 baht will be submit to the revenue department as output tax. Okay, as the output tax. If C is the seller, if C is the buyer, if C is the buyer, C can claim as an input tax when they register themselves as a well registered. Okay, so when making the calculation for the VAT, you can see that when B buy from A, B pay already pay 7 baht. Okay, but in this transaction, when B sell to C, B has the duty to pay revenue department for 21 baht. So, by the mechanism, this kind of the tax collect on the value added among the consumption in each transaction. So this case different between this one is 14 baht will be collect. So B will pay for 14 baht to revenue department on this transaction when B sale to C. Okay, this is total of value added for 200. So these are the the mechanism of the VAT when we focus on the money flow in and flow out. Okay. So in this chapter, you learn about the VAT. So you have to learn a lot of for the factor that related for the consideration of the VAT liability that are the VAT taxpayer, VAT base, VAT rate, and VAT filing. In each one, you have to learn about who is the VAT payer, who will be the VAT payer. They are the person who do the business. They are the business operator. Business that they carry on shall be the VAT service, VAT product or VAT service. I will call it other VAT business. So that is the type of the income that's subject to the VAT. You have to identify what is the VAT business, which kind of the business subject to the VAT. Okay, that is the meaning. After the business operator doing the VAT business, they are required to be VAT registered by making the VAT registration. However, it has an exemption of the VAT registration. What are the VAT registration mean? Which kind of the transaction is exempt for the VAT registration, or which kind of the VAT taxpayer or VAT or business operator that are exempt for the VAT registration, or has the choice to register themselves or not to register themselves. After they identify which for the business that's subject to the VAT, you can know that you have the right, you have the accountability to register as a registrant. Okay. When the taxpayer or the VAT operator become the VAT registrant, they have to identify VAT base, and the VAT base will be collect for the VAT for the correct VAT rate. Okay, VAT business, they are required to collect for the VAT by identify the number of the VAT base, the correct base to calculate for the VAT 7% or 0%. Okay, and the point that they have to charge VAT is called as tax point. You have to learn that, you have to understand that which point of the consumption, okay, in the supply chain, in the consumption line, is as many activity incur in that transaction. So you have to understand that in which point that the VAT registrant has liability to collect VAT. Okay, so they have to understand the VAT will be collect at the point that the VAT liability incur, and then identify the VAT base multiplied VAT rate. That are the number of the VAT that they have to charge in the transaction. In each transaction, VAT operator, they have the responsibility. We call it as role and responsibility of the VAT registrant, even in the position of the buyer or in the position of the seller. Okay, so what is their role? VAT is called as output tax when the VAT registrant is the seller. It will call as an input VAT when the VAT registrant is the buyer. However, in the calculation each month, since I have already told you that the VAT calculation is based on the monthly basis, by bring the number of the output tax of the month minus input tax of the month. However, the number of the input tax that they can use to deduct from the output tax, you have to check for that. Is it input tax which the law do not allow them to deduct in the calculation of the VAT liability in each month? It's called as non-deductible input tax. So, output tax, VAT liability is calculated by bring the number of the output tax of the month minus the deductible input tax of the month. If it is surplus, if it is overpaid, VAT can be refunded. If it is not overpaid, it has the total of it has the number that they have to pay. It is the VAT payable. Okay. For the number of the refundable, it has two ways for the refund, that are cash refund and credit refund. What are the mechanism of the cash refund or credit refund? After you have know the mechanism and all of the definition of the VAT that related to the calculation and related to the documentation, that is the role and responsibility of the taxpayer or the VAT operator. Okay, document that used is called as tax invoice that the seller required to issue to the buyer as an evidence. Tax invoice has the condition for the preparation. Okay, the element that should or must be include in the tax invoice. What are they? How to make the tax invoice? How to prepare the tax invoice? Okay. The tax invoice is include for the receive from the revenue department or custom department when you when the taxpayer bring the or import the product or the service from other country. Okay, debit note and credit note can be used as a tax invoice in which case doing the VAT report for summarizing of the output tax, input tax, and in case if they are the product seller, they have to prepare for VAT report for inventory report. Making the calculation in each month, preparing the tax return. The tax return, we have two tax return form for doing the VAT submission. For the first one, we call it PP30 or PAW30 for the submission of the monthly VAT. And another one we call it as a PP36 for the submission of the VAT for in case of the VAT payment for the international transaction when they're making this payment to abroad. Okay. And the same, if they do not comply to the law, even for the preparing of the tax invoice, for the making of the transaction calculation, doing some compliance that the VAT payer require for doing that, it has a penalty and surcharge. So penalty and surcharge normally is this one time of the VAT or two times of the VAT collection in each tax invoice. The surcharge 1.5%. Is this the same for the rate of the surcharge? However, for the penalty, one time or two times of the number of the VAT, this is vary to the type of the mistake or the type of the uncompliance of the VAT payer, VAT taxpayer. Okay, so this one you have to check for which compliance that the taxpayer do not comply to ensure for the correct of the penalty. So these are the overall part that you have to learn in the VAT session. Okay, we will continue on the step by step in each criteria or in each factor. Okay, and we will see you in next script.